What is up, YouTube? Poor man's guide to you here with Zach today with his wonderful Monarch Xyz.
Very innovative.
Alrighty.
Most innovative.
Let's get into it.
So obviously you've got 3 Aether.
Yep. Pretty standard.
3 Erebus. I actually think this is incorrect. I was just doing it for today just to see. You should definitely be playing 2. The percentage of opening up with a large Monarch from 5 to 6 only goes up by like 8%, so it's not worth it. But you still need to have 9, which is why you play 3 Kiras. This is the most efficient number to run for Tenacity. You have a 60% chance of hitting one of those 9, and after that it goes up by like 4%, so it's not worth it to play more than that. Kiras is also the most optimal one to summon off of Aether, obviously, for the clear interactions in the mirror match. It also allows you to play the mirror match in a similar manner to Necroz, where you would clear your field. But it's also the best one to draw on turn 1, other than Erebus, if you can facilitate the Erebus play, because summoning Kiras and backing up with return to destroy the return and search is the strongest play you can do with Aether.
Yep.
Got 2 red layers. I didn't play blue layer today. Should have.
So why only 2 red layers? Sorry.
2 red layers is all you need. You never want to see it past turn 3.
Yeah.
Assuming you've drawn well, you should already be winning the game. And really, it's just there if you happen to have your setup broken, which you shouldn't. Because you're playing. The deck has the strongest engine in the game right now. So your setups shouldn't be getting broken easily if you're playing the deck correctly.
Gotcha.
Then 2 Adea, 2 Eidos, and 1 Mithra. These 4 are actually really, really bad. In a way, they are. They're actually the strongest engine for the Monarchs, but they're also the most inconsistent in that past the first Adea, all of the subsequent draws are terrible. Mithra being the only one that's relatively useful. You really only play them if you play the Brilliant Fusion build, which is why I play Garnet.
Yep.
But if I wasn't playing Brilliant Fusion, I would take out these 5, and I would play Teratops and Ticketenborg, which are much more efficient. They are not ever dead draws. They allow you to play Instant Fusion. You have a much longer game because of them. The biggest benefit to playing Idea Eidos, honestly, is the second tribute, or the two, able to facilitate two tribute summons off of one card. Getting a spell back isn't even relevant. You shouldn't need to get back your spells. Then for spells, 3.
So there's 3 return clock at all, or you like?
No, you need to have 3, because along with needing to see it on turn 1 with Kiraz, it's also the best one to send other than a Pantheism and Prime.
Yep.
And one mistake a lot of players make is they'll instantaneously send Pantheism Prime every time.
Yeah.
And after your first Pantheism goes to grave, you really don't want to send anymore unless you need to search for a specific card on the next turn that you cannot hard draw. So you usually start sending additional copies of Return. And that's why you play 3. One Domain, I actually wanted to play 2. This card is much stronger than people will give it credit for. Being able to make rank 6s because of it is very strong. Plus, just, it makes Aether and Erebus much more efficient draws than they already are, which is crazy. 3 Brilliant Fusion, obviously. Card's broken.
Yep.
1 for 1. This is just to help unclog hands. Also, sending red layer off of 1 for 1 and then going Idea Eidos and then tributing for the other red layer has come up a few times. And they just add back the red layer so you get free cards.
So, if you play the Speed Road engine, you take out that card?
Yeah, you take out this.
Okay.
And the Brilliant Fusions, obviously.
Yep.
You'd also take a Foolish Burial. I was just playing this just to have even more ways to access additional copies of Idea, Eidos, and Erebus.
Why did you play Imperial Iron Man? Why did you play Imperial?
Then you've got 3 Prime, Best Trap. Don't need to talk about that. Actually, I do need to talk about this. One thing I see a lot of players do is they'll send all 3 copies to grave, and that is absolutely incorrect. You want to keep 1 copy in your deck, so you can have a better late game to continually resolve your Monarch effects. Other than that, people are fine. And then I mained 2 breakthrough skills.
Okay. How is it today?
I don't like it at all. I don't like trap cards.
Do you have any decks besides Cosmo?
The reason I did this was because it's essentially four copies of Effect Failures, and I wanted to have something in the main deck for the mirror match other than Stormforth, I guess.
Yeah. Extra decks?
Yeah. So the extra deck, you got Pleiades.
Yep.
Only one. You only need one. It's only good against Burning Abyss. And I guess Phantom Knight. Durandal. Zen Maya, which comes up a lot more when you play Terra Top.
Yep.
One Magna Liger. Interesting thing that comes up with this is a lot of the times you will summon this when you tribute your red layer.
Mm-hmm.
Summon this back and you'll overlay into Gaia Dragon.
Yeah.
And that comes up a lot because this can't attack when you have no materials.
Why is he in a purpose?
Two Vulcansaurus. I would actually only play one because you can get it back off of Erebus, which is something people don't seem to notice because they don't know how to read their cards. Shark Fortress, because it's
good.
Cool.
Yeah.
Tyrus to out Rivalry. Adrius to out Master Restrict, obviously. These are all obvious. Ptolemy M7. This is just in case you open up with Domain and an ability to summon Aether, because then you can summon this to add Aether back to hand, and then you have this to tribute. A lot of times you also have a Stormforth because you've sent Pantheism, so that's cool. Gaia Dragon, obviously. Hope. This card is actually really not worth playing. You never make Crankites. And then I played 2 Omega. This is because of the win button play.
Yeah.
Where you just summon Megas of Warg and then you send a bunch of cards from both players' extra decks to the graveyard. You send these, so then you can put them back along with other cards from your extra deck or your main deck. And that's cool. Would have come up if I didn't fuck up. That's cool. And then Seraphonite, part of that garbage engine. For a side deck, this way. You got the win button. This is for the mirror match.
You need the Ignister.
So the play here is you trigger return. You try to have a way to summon, I think it's Aether, and then you trigger return, and then you grab this off of return, and then during your turn, their turn, you flip this. I don't know. There's this really weird, complicated play to do it. There's like a really cool way you can have this and Aether out and then you destroy Aether with an Erebus in graveyard and you add back Aether during their turn to keep using it because it's not once per turn. Three Veilers for the mirror match. One Dark Simorgh for
stun.
Any Demise deck. And then
you use him?
It's also actually if the mirror match sides Stygian Dirge, you actually side this in. Because then you can just summon this and make rank 6s.
Yep.
Never comes up, but. Majesty's Fiend for Burning Abyss and Cosmo. Two Maxis. I actually want to drop this card altogether.
Really?
It's fucking terrible. Seriously, the card is not good right now. It's only good against Burning Abyss and Phantom Knights, and even that, you should already be winning. You're playing a stronger deck.
Yeah.
But I want to be able to draw into my Aethers to disrupt their plays. That's the only reason I do it. Three Twin Twisters, which you should be maining at least one copy of, preferably two.
Yeah,
I dropped them for more engine cards. And then two Chaos Trap Bowls, just a rematch.
Yep.
That was it.
Alright, thank you very much.